came about very quickly over the course of about a year, because the genesis of it really was the murder of George Floyd. In that moment, I thought, where is art? How does art respond to a crisis, a catastrophe like this? And that was when I thought of the Sound Suit series by Nick Cave. And you can see an example right behind me. The first Sound Suit was made entirely out of twigs, and it was conceived as armor and camouflage for the black body against state-sanctioned violence. And it was made in 1992 in direct response to the beating of black civilian Rodney King in 1991 by the LAPD. And over time, the sound suits went from being camouflaged to being really unabashedly visible. They still protect the body, they're still armor, and they still obscure our physical features in a way that you can't make prejudicial judgments about sex or gender or race, and yet they cannot presume to hide. And there was something about that ethos of resistance through visuality that reminded me of carnival. And carnival practices, you know, all over the world, there's been sort of folk traditions of taking a moment to dress in something you would never wear before, don a mask or makeup or what have you, and for a moment to reimagine society and social orders in a brand new way. And so the carnivalesque, that became sort of a guiding ethos to this exhibition. I was really interested in the number of artists who are really not only putting themselves in front of the camera, but also doing so in these incredible looks of their own imagining. They're counteracting a photographic and visual history that's really been dominated by a very narrow sense of what normality looks like. Many of the artists in this exhibition are featured more than once, so that we're seeing the same body but transforming in different aspects of identity as these are brought forward. And so if the world is always in a fluid and malleable state according to the identities of the people who inhabit it, then it falls to us to collectively imagine better ways forward. And I think that having the visual reference to that and expanding our social imagination is key to that. That's something that Carnival does, and it's something that I hope Interior Infinite can begin to do as well.